Welcome back to the class on digital image processing. In the previous class, we have discussed about representation of the image in digital format. Next, we have studied the different arrangements of the pixels, that is the basic element of an image. And then we will see that slide. So this one is the basic sensor element, which converts the energy in the visible spectrum into its equivalent electrical form, that is voltage waveform. Now these sensors are arranged in one dimensional array or in a two dimensional array. Now this is the general way of capturing a digital image. The basic requirements are: we need to have a energy source, object to be imaged, we need to have an imaging system, and then we need to have a sensor array. And then once we are having the sensor array, we will be using sampling and quantization to get a digitized image. In this class, we will learn how to sample and quantize the intensity values to get a digitized image. Sampling and quantization. Here, the output of most sensor is in continuous form. Here, the sensor is a sensor which is sensitive to visible spectrum of the light, which converts the energy in the visible spectrum to its equivalent voltage waveform. And that waveform will be in continuous form. So, to create a digital image, we need to convert the continuous sensed data into digital form. So, what are the steps involved in this one? There are two main steps involved in this digitization process. The first one is sampling, and the second one is quantization. Right? Now, we'll go with one, converting this particular object and into a digital one. If we use the source of light as the sun, then the sun rays fall on this object. We just go back to the previous slide. Right here, the rays of light will fall on the object to be imaged, and all the rays that fall on this object are passed through a imaging system, which consists of a pinhole camera, or this imaging system is also called as a pinhole camera. And there inside this one, you will have the sensors arranged in this square array form. Now in that one, if we consider one particular row, say this one particular row, so it starts from point A, right? And from here, it goes on up to point B. Now, if the sensor array along this one collects the converts the visible spectrum energy into the voltage waveform, then it will look like something like this. See here, A. This corresponds to white light. This corresponds to white light. Now, this A and the white light will have an intensity value and higher value. So that's why it is at an higher value. Now, exactly at this point, from white to the object surface is black. So suddenly the intensity drops from higher value to a lower value. And from here to this midpoint, if you look at, then the intensity values are slowly, gradually increasing towards the white. And from this point to the this particular point here, then the intensity values are again gradually decreasing towards the dark side. And exactly at this point, the intensity value suddenly goes back to the highest value, that is white. Now, this waveform, as you look at this waveform along the line A to B, it is continuous in nature, right? Now, if you take this onto an axis, say this is the x-axis, this is the x-axis, and say this is the y-axis. Now, on the x-axis, what we will do is, we will fix the coordinates by sampling this waveform, continuous waveform along the line A to B. See, here there is one sample, and here there is second sample, here there is third sample. Meaning, if we assume that this particular line, if this entire matrix say 100 by 100, then if you treat this line as say some 60 comma 1, so this particular sample will have the coordinates, this sample will have the coordinates 60 comma 1. Likewise, 60 comma 2, 60 comma 3, 60 comma 4. Like that, from A to B, then the last point will be 60 comma 100. So, what we have done here? Only we have obtained the sample coordinates or sample locations in this sensor array. Now, once we have got the sample location, and there in the next step, we will quantize the value at that location. Say 60 comma 1, if it is the sample value, whatever the sample value is there, that one will be quantized. So here, this quantization strip will have range from 0 to 255. That is, a pixel can sense an intensity value in 256 levels. In 256 levels, it can sense one of them. Now, what it will do next in the quantization process, at a given location, whatever the sample value is there, that sample value will be mapped to one of these 256 levels. So, if it is, see, intensity is white here and the bottom intensity is black. Top intensity is white, bottom intensity is black. Now, this one will be very nearly mapped to this high intensity value, that is in and around 255. Now, this particular value will be mapped to around say 80 or 90. Likewise, each and every sample and that sample's intensity value will be mapped to one of the 256 intensity levels. So here what we have done, the amplitudes are quantized. Then finally, we are going to get something, an image like this. Now here, if you look at, we have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, like this. So these correspond, each one location is there for this intensity value, there is a location, and it has got an a finite value, and that finite set is say to one of the 256 gray values. So continuous waveform obtained from the sensor array is processed in two steps. One is sampling, and the next step is quantization. Then you are going to get a digital image. Next, if you look at this one, a continuous image projected onto a sensor array. This is the sensor array grid that you are viewing now, sensor array, and this is the object that is being projected. Now, this one is B, so result of image sampling and quantization. Result of image sampling and quantization. Here you can clearly see the object contour, that is outline of the object is continuous, but when it is converted to digital, then the outline of the object is not smooth. This is the artifact of the sampling and digitization. Next, we will study about neighbors of pixels. Now, given an image, say an image, nothing but a matrix. Image is nothing but a matrix. Now, here we have 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, if we have a digital image f of x comma y, f of x comma y, consider a pixel p at spatial location x comma y. So what I'll do is I'll keep the pixel p here, assume, right, pixel p here, and the coordinates of this one are x comma y. X comma y. Now the pixel p at spatial location x comma y has 4 horizontal and vertical neighbors whose coordinates are given by, see this one, so this one and this one, these two and these two are horizontal, so this is your horizontal and this is your vertical. So what is the location of the horizontal one? It is, say if this is x comma y, this one will be x comma y minus 1, x comma y minus 1, x comma y plus 1. This one will be x comma y plus 1, and this one will be x minus 1 comma y, and the bottom pixel will be x plus 1 comma y. So the pixels which are in the horizontal and which are in vertical above and below are called 4 neighbors of the pixel p located at location x comma y. So this set of pixels is called are called 4 neighbors of P, and it is denoted by 4 neighbors of P, n subscript 4 of P says that 4 neighbors of pixel P at a location x comma y, at a location x comma y. Next, the pixel p at spatial location x comma y has 4 diagonal neighbors whose coordinates are given by, say again you take this one part of the digital image, I'll take now only 4, so in the previous 4 neighbors they are 1, 2, 3, and 4. So now the diagonal are this one, second pixel, third diagonal neighbor, and fourth diagonal neighbor of this particular pixel P. So their coordinates are x plus 1 comma y plus 1, x plus 1 comma y minus 1, x minus 1 comma y plus 1, x minus 1 comma y minus 1. So this set of pixels is denoted by 8 neighbors, diagonal neighbors of P. They are diagonal neighbors of P. Now, 4 neighbors of P and diagonal neighbors of P, these two are called 8 neighbors of P, denoted by 8 neighbors of P. So if someone says in the image, if a pixel P 8 neighbors, then they will be 2 horizontal, 1, 2, 2 vertical, so total 4 neighbors, and 4 diagonal neighbors. All these 8 are the neighbors of the pixel P. In the next class, we will learn about adjacency, connectivity, regions, and boundaries.